Hi guys, welcome to our new video. In this video, we are discussing the mandatory previous coding questions asked. Here we are discussing one question that asked in the last year. So this is the question. We are given two cases, that is n is equal to 3 and n is equal to 5. For n is equal to 3, the output is 3 ones, then 2, then 3, then 3 twos, then 3 threes, then 4. Here we can see a pattern of 1, 3, 1, 3, 2, and 3, 3. But in alternative format, 2, 3, 4 are printed. Here 2 means n minus 1, that is 3 minus 1. Here 2 means n minus 1. Then n minus 1 is incremented by 1, that is printed here, 3. Then again it is incremented, that is 4, that is printed in alternative format. The same case here. For n is equal to 5, we have given 3 5, 5 5s, that is 5 1s, sorry. We have the output is 5 1s, then 4, then 5, then 5 2s, then 5 3s, then 6. The same style as n is equal to 3. That is, the in alternative format, then minus 1 is printed. Here the n is equal to 5, that means n minus 1 is 4. Then it is incremented and printed in alternative style. This is the question. So let's do the code for this. For this, we have to initialize some variables. That is int I, j, I and j for row and column. I think most of you know about this. For a pattern, we have to do two for loops. For the two for loops, we use two variables. First we check for n is equal to 3. So these are the variables we first initialize. Then we create a for loop with variable I equal to 1, then I less than or equal to n, then increment I, that is I plus plus. Inside that for loop, we create another for loop, that is for j equal to 1, j less than or equal to n, then j plus plus. Inside that, we print the I value. So first we have to check what will be the output for this code. So here we are checking the output for. So we got the output as 3 1s, then 3 2s and 3 3s. So we have to print this in a line format. That means we have to print these three patterns in a three lines. For that, we just give a line, that is slash n. Okay, now the output will come in a three lines. Yes, in three lines. So now we created almost the 50% of the code. Now we have only to give some conditions for this. These two conditions, I said two conditions, these two conditions are for printing the alternative formats. For that, I create a condition if I modulus 2 equal to 1, that means odd number. Then I print value p. So then we increment the value of p with 1. So I have to initialize the p value, that is p is equal to n minus 1. So we created almost the 90%. First, so we check what will the output for this code. Yeah, we got 2 and 3 in alternative formats here. Now we have to give only one condition. That is, if I modulus 2 equal to 0, that is for even, that means it is even. Then we print the value of p, then increment that value with 1. So now we check what will be the output. So here we got the output, that is 111, then 2, then 3, then 3 2s, 3 3s and 4. We checked the case for 3. Let's check for n equal to 5. Yeah, we got the output. So this is the code for this question. This is the question that asked in the last year. I shared the code for this question in the description. If you want more questions like this, please join to our Telegram group. I shared the link of the Telegram group in the description, and please subscribe and share our videos.